And welcome back. This is Eldritch. And unfortunately, the game does not look as good as this title screen. This is a pretty damn good title screen. But the game's pretty fun anyway. Oh boy. I might have to, this should be fine. I'm just not used to playing in a window. I thought the mouse speed was too low, but this should be fine. Yeah, the game looks a lot like Minecraft. A lot of voxels. It's not the prettiest game ever, but I still think it is pretty good. This is the hub world. There are fruit you can eat to heal yourself between levels. You can hold shift to run. There's a mirror over here that you can use to examine your character, and there are a few appearance options. As you can see, I kind of have a Lara Croft thing going on. Kind of neat, not really any point to it since you never really see your character during the game. This is the New Game Plus item, the Soul of the Librarian. I have finished this game. I haven't gotten the good ending or done the New Game Plus. When you pick this up, it activates the New Game Plus, which just makes the game way more difficult. There are three areas in the game. There's this is the first one, I think. Yeah, that's the first area. And you can kind of leave and come back to the hub world in between levels. Like Spelunky, you can unlock the ability to go to later worlds, you know, a shortcut to the later worlds, but I don't really recommend it, since it's a good idea to, go through them in order. There's a soul at the end of each of these levels, and once you get all three souls, you bring them over here, and you put them on these pedestals to open the library, which is the end game. And I did that the other day. I'm not going to do the New Game Plus at the moment, so I will just resurrect and start anew. I can call you Bippo. Okay. Sounds good. Sounds better than Bippo Ernesti. Oh, that's okay, that's two words. Bippo Ernesti. I was pronouncing it as one word. Bippo Ernesti. Alright, so let's jump right into it. Oh, the reason F is the use key is because you can use Q and E to lean. The game audio seems quiet to me. This game doesn't have a ton of audio. A lot of ambient music. There's always a compass at the beginning of level 1. At least when you're not doing New Game Plus. Levels are randomly generated. When you loot the corpse of an enemy, it disappears and respawns elsewhere in the level. So it's definitely a risk versus a reward thing going on there. I want to head back to the hub world and heal because I took a point of damage there. And also, this is the only persistence in the game, besides being able to unlock shortcuts, is your money chest. This stays no matter what. And sometimes there will be a chest in the level itself, so you can take out money and put in money in the middle of a level. And that's your currency for everything in this game, for buying items and for using special abilities. The attack animation looks pretty hilarious. Yeah. It's kind of weird. Despite how silly this game looks, it's still very creepy and tense. Like, it has, you know, it's called Eldritch. It has the whole Lovecraftian motif going on. And it's not really super Lovecraftian. It doesn't really play up the whole insanity aspect of it. But this is a pretty creepy game. The enemy AI is relatively good. There's a lot of sneaking around. A lot of hiding. Ammo is a very scarce resource. Which is why I recommend going through the levels in order. I was hoping that guy didn't notice me, so I could just punch him to death. Luckily, World 1 is pretty easy. The first time I played the game, I only died once in World 1, but it gets much harder later on. You have two item slots. You hit X to cycle between them. So right now I have my gun and the fist. Locked doors. I don't have any keys at the moment. And when you lean, it doesn't affect enemies' line of sight to you. So you can get a good view of the enemies without worrying about them seeing you. This is a statue where you can activate and get a special ability. I haven't actually used this ability that much. That's basically lets you charm an enemy and it'll fight for you. It's kind of interesting. You can pick up a rock. You can pick up the dynamite and throw it. You can hit Z to drop an item. Or you can just punch the dynamite and it'll activate. All the terrain is destructible. There are various ways to dig through the terrain. Those things will shoot fireballs at you, by the way, which is why I'm kind of cautious around them. See, if I had a key, then I could get up what's on the other side of this wall. Or if I had the teleport ability, I could just teleport up there. But I don't. That charm ability costs 7 artifacts to use, so I probably won't be getting too much use out of that for a while. Hi, guy. Ah, crap. Oh, well. You can throw bottles at people, but they break, obviously. The rock you can keep throwing over and over again. Up in the top right-hand corner, you can see the map, which shows you basically where everything is. That little face icon up towards the top is the special ability, the statue that you pray at. The thing that looks like a page is the book you came in. That's a shop on the other side of the book, if I can get there. Ha! Gotcha. Even though I don't have that much money, that many artifacts yet, I can at least show that off. Went ahead and pick up this ham while I'm here. Yeah, I died once in this world the first time I played this game, and it was because I tried to jump over the spikes and I fell on them instead. So let's try not to make that mistake again. There's a pile of artifacts. There's 5 there instead of just 1. Which break the bottles or the people. Well, sometimes both. If you can get a good shot on them. If you can kill enemies before they notice you, you can usually one-shot them. That's not always the case, depending on which enemy it is. But stealth is definitely a big aspect to this game. There's probably nothing good in here, but I'll check it out. Oh, wow. I was mistaken. This is a very good room. Drop that rock to pick up the dagger. Dagger is like your punch, but it does way more damage. Alright. Is there any way for me to get to the shop on this level? See, that's a question you have to ask yourself. Because a lot of times, the way to go is just plain blocked off. And you have to go down and then come back up to get to certain parts of the map. Hey! Damn it! Even with my dagger, he's still got a hit in on me. There's usually not that many rogue guys in this level. They're like the difficult enemy for this part. Of course, I guess these guys have probably respawned a lot since I started out. Alright, let's go in here. The levels are randomly generated, but there are parts of levels that you definitely see numerous times. Like, this is a very standard part of the level, which is how I knew that there would be a lot of good stuff. What's the plot in this game? There are books in the hub area that kind of explain what's going on. Basically, you're just trapped in here, and you have to go through each of these three worlds through the books and get the artifacts to... You know, it's Lovecraft, so there are elder gods involved, and, you know, you have to stop them. Kind of a bare-bones plot, but, you know, I don't really play this kind of game for the plot. God, there's a freaking million of these guys here. All right, let's try to get to the shop, and then I will start heading down, because I've been spending a lot of time on this, on this area. I have a pretty good number of artifacts now. That's a plus. Hi, fish guy. Please buy something, glup glup. How long am I streaming? Probably... I don't know, 9:30 or so. Another 45 minutes, maybe. It depends on how much I get into this game. The destruction amulet makes it so you can shoot parts of the world to dig through them, which is pretty nice. I think I might actually buy that. Lucky Charm makes you find more loot on corpses. First thing I want to do, though, is buy a ham. I can't afford the destruction amulet anymore. Oh well. Medical kit makes you revive if you die. Stealth boots silence your footsteps. Very, very useful. But I don't have enough for those. What happens if you steal from a store? Well, I'm assuming that this guy will kick your ass. I haven't actually tried stealing from the store, but I did try attacking this guy, and he will kill you pretty handily, so I haven't risked stealing. See, that's the enemy you see. You usually see this guy more often, the fish guy. He's way easier to kill than those rogue guys. Try stealing the med kit and haul ass. Well, I don't really like stealing in these kinds of games. Like, I never steal from the shopkeeper in Spelunky. I always assume the punishment won't be worth it. There's another ability in here, and I'm pretty sure that's one that I want more than the hypnotize ability. Yeah, that's Knock. That is super useful. That lets you unlock any door by spending 4 artifacts. Very nice. Okay. Anything else on this level I want to check out? Maybe. Sure. I don't really have to worry that much about keys anymore now that I have Knock. Oh yeah, you have a little slide ability if you're running and you hit crouch while you're running. You do, like, a cool little slide. So I can slide through that passage. Yes. Break that bottle. Smashy, smashy. Oh, I guess I might as well loot this corpse. While I'm here. Oh, key. It's pretty nice. Alright, I'm just going to head down. I like how when you're crouching, the edges of the screen kind of go dark. That's a nice touch. There are too many games where I'm just like, am I crouching or not? I can't tell. So, let's crouch. Sneak up behind that snake. I was going to sneak up behind that guy, but he heard that snake die. Oh god. See, since that guy couldn't see me, I got him in one shot. What spell do I have? Knock. It will immediately unlock a door. Like this one. Right click. Boom. I probably should have at least showed off the hypnotize before I switched, but it uses a lot of mana. For some reason, you can pick up daggers when you already have one. It doesn't do anything, but it gives you that ability. Welcome back, Cody Farf. Alright, this is the exit over here, so let's get the heck out of here. Hi, fishman. Oh, man. Can't attack while you're on the ladder. You can jump and attack, though. Something about this game reminds me of PSX-era adventure games. Yeah, I can kind of see that. Although I never played many adventure games on the PSX. The graphics do kind of have that feel. They're a little more more detailed than Minecraft, I think. I don't know. I haven't played Minecraft in a while. Eat some meat. Alright. Yeah, I just have to go around to get to the exit. Bam! Backstab. Oh! Hi. I usually don't have this many keys this early in the game. Alright. Nothing else here. Let us head down. How do you breathe underwater? You don't? I don't think this game has water. Or do you just mean in general? With a scuba tank? With air bubbles? I don't know, is that a riddle? You are underwater, right? No, I don't think so. I think this is just like a dungeon. And the stuff growing on the walls is just moss. Oh, because of the fish people? No, those are land fish people. Oh, the spell looks like bubbles. No, I think that's supposed to be a, like an audio wave icon. That does look kind of weird now that I think about it. Another shop on this floor. See, if you look at the map, there's a dark line showing you where you can't go. It's not, I don't know how visible that is on the stream, but this is a self-contained area. Like, there's no way for me to get to that shop or that statue without going down and coming back up. So, I have to drop down here and then find another way up if I want to get to those parts of the map. This thing's already dead. That's weird. This game does have enemy infighting too, which is pretty cool. If an enemy accidentally attacks another enemy, then they will fight to the death, which I guess is how these things are already dead. Oh, you can also use the knock to, like, distract enemies, I think. Didn't work on this guy. But, like, if you hit the wall with it, it's supposed to make a sound that, like, attracts their attention. I'm assuming there's fall damage. Yes. It's pretty easy to take fall damage in this game. See, that'll take me back up. Ooh, I really like that ability. I think I'm going to go for that one instead. I have 7 keys. I don't need to. This is the materialized power. It costs 1 artifact to use. And when you have this power, you can create things. Blocks. Which are useful in a number of ways. Which hopefully I will be able to show off later. This is rotten meat. You can tell because It's discolored. Sometimes it gives you a hit point, sometimes it hurts you, so I never pick those up. However, there's a lot of real meat here as well. Hey! Whoa, chill out, snake. Loot you, loot you. If you get a certain amulet, then it reduces the cost of all of your spells, reduces the artifact cost, and since materialize only costs one, if you get that amulet, it means it only costs zero. So you can do it all you want, all day long. Which is actually, I had that combo the first time I finished the game. It is extremely useful. Let's go up here and see if I can get to that shop. Oh wait, no. It's just the same little self-contained area. Well, damn. Gonna have to figure out another way. Hello. Pickness. 12349. Did you notice me? Yeah, I guess you did notice me, huh? Run! Ooh. I'm glad I came this way. There's a fountain here. Fountain heals you by 2 and increases your max HP by 1. So as you can see, I have 4 out of 4 hearts now instead of 3 out of 3. Super, super useful. Obviously. Ooh. I spy another book. I should get there. Nope, I'm going the wrong way. Whee! I heard someone. I really like the enemy voices in this game. They just kind of sound like regular dudes. It's like, huh? Like, they don't sound like monsters. Just kind of fun. Hey! Well, I have 29 bullets. It's pretty good. I'm trying to conserve ammo, by the way, which is why I'm not shooting any of these guys. Because later on, you need a lot of ammo. This game will probably go on a bit longer than Nuclear Throne did, by the way. I really was not expecting to finish Nuclear Throne during the stream. Well, I guess I didn't finish it, but I made it as far as you can make it. Well, I mean, you can loop it, but I explored every area of the game. Let's put it that way. Alright, so where is that book? Okay, we need to figure out how to get to that book. That book is important, and I will explain why when I get there. Now it looks even more like a QR code, yeah? Kinda. That is kind of a weird way to show you what power you have. Jesus! How the heck am I supposed to get to that book? It's like the whole area is blocked off. I don't get it. Alright, well, let's try going up this way. See if I can find another path or something. Do I have to blast my way in there? Was there another path on a higher floor that I didn't see? How do I find these awesome games? Well, Nuclear Throne and Spelunky, Spelunky I discovered. I forget how I found Spelunky. The original freeware version. But these games, Here we go. A nuclear throne in Eldritch, I discovered because of quick looks on giantbomb.com. A whole wealth of awesome games on that site. And they both look fun, so I picked them both up. I usually don't pick up dynamite, by the way. It's useful, but only in limited situations. Actually, it might be useful right here. I can blast my way into that store. Oh. Hello, flying eye. Java King 2014, what's up? I still have a bunch of keys. Let's see what's in here. Oh, speak of the devil. Alright, let's use this dynamite and see if I can brute force my way into that item shop. Hopefully I won't accidentally kill the shopkeeper. Oh! Oh, come on, I should be able to climb that. Well, magic to the rescue. Oh, I have to duck. There we go. Unlike in Zelda, they don't really seem to get pissed off when you bomb their shop. Conjurer's Talisman. That's the one I've been looking for. It costs 25, but when you buy it, you lose your compass, unfortunately, which all it really shows you is, like, it has the hovering thing that shows you that. That shows you where the exit is. That's really all it gives you. And it shows you where the statues are on the map. But when you have the Conjurer's Talisman, you can do this. And it does not cost you a damn thing. Which is so, so useful in the second area of this game. I mean, useful in general, really. But especially in the second area. You can trap yourself, though, so you kind of have to be careful. Oh, that is an unstable statue. I believe that's the one that lets you teleport, but I would rather have the ability to conjure blocks. Hello, Psychic Psycho 3. Block the fission and steal this crap. It's actually an interesting idea. I never really thought of doing that. I think it's worth a try. Oh, I feel bad though. Poor guy. Alright, well, let's see what happens. Oops. Smiles weepily at you. Yeah, you're about to weep, buddy. I feel like an Edgar Allan Poe character. Alright, I'd say he is pretty well blocked in there. Let's see what happens. Well, he's upset about it. Oh, that's so mean. Wait, did I just automatically steal that since I already stole? Yeah, I guess that's what happens. Why would you ever buy a bottle? That doesn't make any sense. Oh, grab these keys too. Oh, thank you for suggesting that, Pippo. That was a good idea. I don't know if it'll have any lasting consequences, but I picked up the speed boots, make you run faster, always nice. And the locksmith kit. They just let you unlock doors for free. So it's like having the knock ability and the block ability. Broke the game? I don't think so. I hope not. Oh, you mean I use an OP strat? Yeah, that might be the case. Alright, well, let's get the heck out of here now. What's the I have to go back through the shop the other way. The way I blew a hole inside. Okay. Where's Raconis? What's up? A lot of people in here this time. Yeah, it's awesome. Thanks to everyone who came. This is way better than my usual turnout. Aw. I didn't slide under the thing. I wonder if that will have lasting repercussions on the other shopkeepers. I don't know. Like I said, I've never tried to steal from them before, so I don't know how other shopkeepers will react, if at all. I mean, logically, they shouldn't have any way to know about it. Uh-huh. What's wrong? Can't get to me? Okay. I really like using the blocks to fuck with people when they can't see you. I'm going to have to go back up and come back down to get to the exit, I think. I don't see any way out of this area. Let's go up this way. Oh, jeez. Let's see. Which way have I not been? Well, I haven't been this way. Well, there's no way to go this way. Well, no. Just gonna have to climb my way up. Oops. You can fall an okay distance before you take damage. But fall damage will definitely happen if you're not careful. Alright, if I go down this way, it's just a self-contained area, right? There's no way out of this. Oh, wait. I can go down this way. Yeah. Oh, God. Jesus. Whew. Wow, I'm glad I didn't take more damage there. That fish man is going to have a shotgun and chase me. Yeah, probably. But, you know, life's an adventure. Doing pretty good on ammo, doing pretty good on money. Doing pretty good on keys. Is that a real ham or a fake ham? That is a fake ham. And that's fake fruit, also. Toxic fruit. Well, yes, I think I will eat the toxic fruit. What a great idea. The levels in this game are huge. Yeah, they are pretty damn big. Oops. Well, crap. That didn't help. The exit's in that corner that I didn't fully explore. Oh, I'm going to have to go back up and come back down. It's just a big pain in the ass. See, I can't get to that square without going even further up. The mazes in this level can get a little frustrating. Crap. Alright, so go back up. Go all the way back up to the top floor. Jesus. I can't get out of this area. No, this is the self-contained part again. Damn. I've never run into a situation where you have to use dynamite to get somewhere before. Like, there's always a way out. So I'm not sure. Poor shopkeeper. Alright, well, let's get this ham first. Heal myself up. Alright, let's try going this way. Okay. Yes, I'm on the right track. Alright. I need to go this way. Nope, wrong way. I need to go this way. Go through this. Do this instead of using a key. Uh-huh. Open that up. Oh, wait. I shouldn't have picked that up. I'm getting excited. Don't get ahead of yourself, Duke. And there's no way down in this corner. Great. Oops. Should have left that fruit there. We're just trying to pick up that artifact. Well, where the heck am I supposed to go? This is making me wish I picked up that destruction amulet. I just shoot my way down. Alright. That's a self-contained area. Okay. I've never gotten this lost in this game before. Usually, it's pretty straightforward. Alright, I need to come this way. Go up. Go down over here. Oops. See, another thing that this is very useful for, making a bridge. Alright. I see where I need to go down. Need to go this way. Yes. And then continue going down. Excellent. Apparently I was here and I didn't realize it. And then go this way. And here is the exit. Thank God. Okay. It should be the last part of World 1. I should be pretty close to the quote-unquote boss. Yep, there it is. You just kick the shit out of that flying eye. That thing is unkillable. You have to avoid it. And I did a very poor job of avoiding it. You can hit it all you want, and it will not die. Oop, shit. Jumped on the spikes. Theoretically, you can block that thing in, and it can't get to you. But it's not the easiest thing in the world, and I only have one hit point left. So I really need to stop fucking around and just get the hell away from that thing. Normally I would try to knife that, but I'm not going to take any chances. Oh. A lizard thing. Alright. I do have plenty of keys, so hopefully I'll come across a locked room or something that has some food in it. I hear something. Guess not. I need to be more careful around those snakes. Any food up here? Nope. Lots of dynamite, but no food. Okay. I'm moving a lot faster now that I have these speed boots. It's kind of making me a little careless. This game looks like it would be really easy to get lost. Yeah, I usually don't have that much trouble. Oh, man. I heard it. I didn't know it was next to me. Yeah, you do kind of have to think on multiple levels to be good at this game. I can tweet my, oops. I can tweet my death if I want. It says, RIP, I was bitten by a bug in a murky Dagonite ruin. And it has a link to the game. But I'm not going to do that, since I don't want to spam anyone's feed. I don't know if you can kill those Shoggoth-like things. You can't. It's impossible. I have put like 50 bullets into those things. All right, well, let's give it another go. Damn, I was doing so well, too. Well, hopefully I don't get as lost this time around. That sucked. Found a gun right off the bat. That's pretty good. I don't want it drawn yet, though. Shop. Destruction amulet, jump boots, tinning kit lets you eat corpses you find for an additional cost. Get some health back. I haven't found that it's really that useful. None of this stuff is really that useful unless I wanted to buy bullets or keys. Does this game get content updates? I don't think so. I think it's as is. I believe the developer is working on porting it to Mac and Linux, I think. And there's no plans to add additional content. But there's a pretty good bit of content in this game. Like, just the three worlds can take a pretty long time. I mean, it took me 7 hours of playing until I finally finished the game. And I still have to get the good ending. And I have to do the New Game Plus. And I have to get the good ending in New Game Plus. Which should be a pretty good bit of time. I don't know if the game will hold my attention for that long. But I at least want to try. Yeah, buddy. Didn't see that one coming, did you? Ooh. What ability is this? Oh. Yeah, unstable is teleport. I was correct. It costs 4. Well, you can put the... I think you can put the thing down for free. Yeah. And then if you want to teleport, it costs 4. And if you can get the conjuration amulet, it only costs 2. It's pretty useful. It's in my top 3 abilities. God, there's a lot of doors here. Who designed this place? Jim Morrison? Oh, kill me. Yeah, this game was released pretty recently, so I'm not really 100% sure about the content updates. But I believe I read something to that effect. Hey, buddy. Oh, he heard me. Alright. Well, the only way down is all the way back here. I don't really know if you get the same creepy ambience from this game that I do. Of course, the first level, I mean, the creepiness comes more from fear of death than anything else. Because it definitely has that tension that, like, classic roguelikes have. I think I like this more than the teleport. Like, I don't really get that tension from Spelunky, since it's so easy to die in that game. And Nuclear Throne, really easy to die in that game. But in this game, you can kind of go for a while between deaths. And it really makes it tense when you're about to die. I love it when I unlock a door and there's 2 keys in there. really feels good to spend keys and make keys. I wonder if the spikes are mechanical or organic. Oh, I don't know. The way they're pulsating seems to indicate that they're organic. Everything Lovecraftian gives me the Wiggins. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't really play up the whole insanity aspect that a lot of Cthulhu-inspired games do. And the monsters are kind of goofy-looking. But even with all that, it's still... I don't know. Did that guy hear me? I don't think so. Stab! Come on. Keep bouncing along, fish guy. Doesn't seem that there's any point in sneaking in the first world. Well, you can sneak up behind enemies and they're easier to kill. But yeah, in world 2 and 3, I don't loot the enemies' bodies at all. Just because I would rather the enemies not respawn. Which is why I never skip world 1. Because world 1 is where you get all of your resources. Oh, fountain. Nice. I thought I heard something bubbling. Alright. Doesn't look like there's anything else of note on this floor, so I'm just going to head down. Yeah, if you don't hear any background music, this game doesn't have a lot of it. I could try to turn it up if you want me to. It's up to you. Hey. I like that we had the same reaction to each other. He was like, huh? And I was like, hey. And then he was like, Wunstaffel. Or whatever the guys in Wolfenstein say. It sounds like Wunstaffel. But my German is not great. I wonder if I can get up and stab that eye before it shoots me. Or I can just aggro it. Ah! Woo! That was close. I think it was Schutzstaffel or something. Yeah, it was something like that. One of those German-sounding words. See, that's the material is... I always forget what the spell's called. And there's no way to look at it after you get it. But yeah, that's the block spell again. Doesn't look like there's anything else of note on this floor. Of course, you know, stuff like fountains don't show up on the map. So you do kind of want to give the place a good once-over. And also, if you want to get the good ending, then you have to go into these sub-worlds. But luckily, those do show up on the map. And there's one right here. See if I can get to it. Stab. With the stealth boots, you can just run up to people. You don't have to dick around. I'm gonna have to go around to get to that book. Well, damn it. See, this is where it gets annoying, because there's an item shop and a book, and I can't get to either of them without going down and then coming back up. Or there might be a way I can go up and then come back down, but not really want to... Hey! I tried to be awesome and stab that guy on the way down, but he wasn't having it. Okay, well, this is just a tiny little area here, so I'm going to have to go back up and come back down. I'm climbing, by the way. I don't really know if that's obvious what's happening, but you can climb obstacles up to a certain height. Ooh, fountain. Don't mind if I do. Glad I explored that more thoroughly. Okay. I need to... Oh, wait a second. I haven't gone down this way yet, have I? No, that's the way I did go down. I need to go down the other way and see what's down there. 5 hit points now. I'm doing okay. Alright, this is the other way down. Is this a self-contained area as well? Hard to tell. Can you save in this game? Yes, but it's a save and quit deal. So you can't save scum. I guess theoretically you can copy your save. Oh god. If you really want to cheese it, you can save and quit and then make a backup copy of your save and save scum that way. But I'm not going to do that. That wouldn't be very roguelike. Well, if I recall, I think you can do that in Rogue as well. It had the same save and quit mechanic, and I'm pretty sure it would work just fine if you made a backup copy of the save. But that's for losers. Yeah, way too much effort for not much advantage. I hear someone. Is this really all that's in here? Man, you suck. Oh, there's some artifacts. Well, okay. I guess I'm glad I came down here. There's another artifact. Alright, so I want to go up. I think I want to keep going up. Hey! Oh man, this is another maze. If I want to get to that book. See, it's right there! It is right behind that wall. And I cannot get to it. Anything over here? No. See, it is right behind that wall. Alright, well, let's, haven't gone down this way yet. I think that's just that little self-contained... No. Oh, no, it is. Maybe there's dynamite somewhere I can use. God, this is frustrating. I've never had this much trouble getting to somewhere I want to go in this game. Although it did have like a build number on the main menu screen. So maybe he is making, or they, I don't know if it's a guy or, I think it's just one guy, actually. Maybe he is making updates. Hello, Adfecta. Nice to meet you. My name's Duke, and I like to play video games. Have I played FTL? No, that's another one I own, but I haven't played because I'm too intimidated by it. I really should play that at some point. Okay. I think I see a way I haven't gone. Oh, God. Whew. That was close. I mean, FTL is kind of like, it's sort of a pseudo RTS, Like, there's a lot of managing things at the same time in real time. And I'm really bad at that. Which is why I haven't tried it yet. Oh. Hi, guy. Alright. Well, I can go up here. Which I think is... Can I go up here? It says I can on the map. Oh, yeah. This way. Alright. I believe I can get to the store. Well, I guess I spoke too soon. Man, it really does not want me to get to that store or that book. Oh, at least I'm getting lots of items. Pinfeldorf, what's up? You're here well after my bedtime. Well, it's Friday, so I don't have a bedtime. I can stay up as late as I want. Sometimes on Friday, I stay up to 11 o'clock. I know, living life on the edge. I think I am going to utilize some of this dynamite. Oh crap, I'm not on the right floor anymore. No, that's the exit. Okay. There's another way up here. Is that thing alive? No. Okay. Oh wait, I've been here, right? Alright. Oh, there's a store. Great, excellent. You better have something worth buying. Oh, that is worth buying. I will buy the Conjurer's Talisman. I will be a dick, and I will help myself to everything else you have. Man, I really like this strategy. Oh, let's see, I think I'll take those and some of that, even though I don't really know how useful it is. Take the dagger. Why not? Oh. Oh my god. I threw the dagger and it bounced back and hit me. A Lobster Johnson, what's up? I think I follow you on Twitter. But I don't know if I've ever actually seen you in a stream. So welcome. Thanks for coming. Alright, well I don't need this dynamite. Well, actually I might need the dynamite. If I still want to get to that book, which is right there in that little central area. Okay, is there anything else in here that I want? I get so confused. What's going on? Why is it so dark? Okay. I can always find another dagger. So let's go this way. No, can't go that way. Okay, let's go this way. Hate to waste a bullet on a snake, but I don't want to throw dynamite at him either. Okay. I got the jump boots too, by the way, which makes me jump significantly higher, which is pretty nice. Another thing that the spell is very good for. Is oh well, I fell on the spikes anyway. Usually if you run you just kind of skip over that, but they didn't hurt me for some reason, so I guess I'm lucky. Unfortunately you can't put a block directly on the spikes, like you can't cover the spikes with the block. Alright, I want to go up here, right? And then come back down. See, one shot at that guy, since he wasn't expecting me. Baron Creel? Oh, you were here before. Welcome back. Hey! Oh man, I'm wasting a lot of bullets, so I can hang on to this dynamite. Well, I might not need it. fall damage. Whatever. I have 30 bullets. And I can always just find another shop and steal all the bullets I need. Of course, there's no guarantees that I'll find a shop. Alright. That's where the book would be, right there. So I'm going to throw dynamite right there. See what I get. Didn't work. Okay, well. It's worth a shot, I guess. Oh, wait. If I go up this way, yeah, I think I found it. No. Damn it! Okay. Screw it, I'm out of here. I'm not going to spend this much time trying to find... I hear people shooting fireballs at me. Wish I had my dagger again, but I don't. I guess I should figure out how this tending kit works. Oh, it has to be a non-human creature, so it doesn't work on these guys. I think it'll give me the option, and it'll just tell me to hold F to eat the corpse and gain some health back. Alright, I'm out of here. This level is pissing me off. It's pissing me the damn heck off. Oh yeah. It had the option hold F to eat the corpse. But it costs 20 to do that though, which kind of sucks. Alright. I'll be right back. It's never worth it to eat rotten stuff. I agree. The chance of taking damage is just, it's not worth it. Why is the rotten stuff there? To troll you. Alright, I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Sorry about that. This is a long stream. But you know, I'm having fun. I hope you're all having fun too. Man, I have a lot of keys. Another dagger. Nice. I hear... Oh god. Those things make the same bubbling sound as the fountain, by the way. So, luckily, when you're not doing the New Game Plus, they only show up on the last floor of this area. Oh, there's a fountain, too. Fan-fucking-tastic. Hey, chill out, guy. Yes. Excellent. Okay. I need not to get too excited. This is very similar to the loadout that I had last time. Gotta take it easy. One step at a time. Quite an entertaining game to watch. Yeah, that's what I hoped. I mean, I think roguelikes are always really entertaining. Since, you know, it's never the same twice. And there's always, you know, a real element of suspense to it. See, I can leave that thing if I want by holding F. But I have full health, and there is a Shoggoth coming my way. Shoggoth. So I am running in the opposite direction. Damn it. I knew I was about to hit those spikes. Couldn't help it. Oh, God. I knew I was about to hit them again. I need to get away from that thing. Oh, Christ. Oh, Christ. It'd be really cool. You know what would be really cool? If I could lure the thing in here and then block it in. I don't think that's very likely, though. It's too smart to let that happen. Alright, I still haven't found a way down on this floor. God, you suck. Oh man, I took so much damage there. But I think I lost it. For now. See, I don't want to like, block off an entire area. Because I don't want to accidentally trap myself anywhere. So I kind of have to be a little bit conservative. Oh man, I should have eaten that thing. Oh well. I have to be a little conservative. Once you loot them, you can't eat them, by the way. Their body disappears. Alright. I will eat. Oh, you still get the stuff from them, too. That's cool. And I will eat you. And I will eat you. That was a lot of artifacts I just used. Kind of wish I didn't take all that damage. Now, let's see. I could heal myself up all the way if I want. Oh wait, there's a tree. Nice. Don't have to spend money. Alright, let's loot all of these things. Alright, back to full health. That's what I should have done the last time. Make myself a little elevated bridge. How did I get the eat power? That's a tending kit that I stole from the shopkeeper. It gives you the ability to tend enemies, which like preserves them, I guess. It's there's a similar ability in NetHack. It lets you tin monsters, which is like British for can. Put them in a tin or a can. Or a tin can. I mean, in this game, it doesn't really make as much sense, since, you know, the bodies are still fresh and everything, but it might be, I don't know, it might just be a direct NetHack reference. I'm close. I think this is it. Yes, excellent. I got the Soul of Diagon, and I am getting the heck out of here. Alright, now that we have the first soul, we can run over here and put it on the pedestal. And that is 1 of 3. You can walk across spikes, and they only hurt you if you sprint or land on them. Oh, okay. Well, that's good to know. Alright. Have I tried Rogue Legacy? Yes, someone mentioned that, but I have not played it yet. It is definitely on my list. The White Soul is the soul of the Librarian. That activates the New Game Plus. That's right, you guys weren't here when this game started. Sorry. I think I'm going to keep going. That is Area 3. I'm going to at least show off Area 2. I don't know if I'll finish it during this stream. But yeah, Rogue Legacy looks fun as hell. I haven't picked it up yet for some reason. Too many roguelikes to keep up with. Yeah, exactly. I mean, once I finish The Binding of Isaac, I was like, well, damn. Now I need a new roguelike. Like, oh, lizard people. These guys take a lot of hits to go down, and they shoot fireballs at you. Actually, I'm not going to loot their corpses, because I would rather they not reappear. Although having the ability to eat them instead does add... This is a trap. You can hit F to disarm it, and it gives you a bullet. Having the ability... Well, I don't know. They probably still respawn, even... Yeah, because they give you the stuff as well. So yeah, I won't be eating anything unless I absolutely... Eating any corpses unless I absolutely have to. Hello, Missy Shade. Nice to see you. How's it going? I am doing pretty good on resources, actually. That is a lizard statue, and that's another reason I like having these blocks around. The statues, you can blow them up with dynamite, but if they see you, then they activate, and then you have to keep line of sight on the statues, or else they just teleport to you and hurt you. If you've ever seen Doctor Who, I think they were like angel statues or something, they kind of work like that. You have to keep looking at them until you break line of sight behind a wall or something. I think they were angel statues. I've never actually seen that episode, but I believe they are similar. Kind of wish I didn't take a point of damage there. Oh god. Kind of wish I didn't take another point of damage there. Alright. I will eat that. And I will eat that. But that's it. I have to watch my figure, after all. Weeping angels, yes, that's it. Yes, the statues work like that. You can't blink. I mean, you don't blink anyway, but you know. These gravestones are just decoration. I tried to figure out if they actually do something, but I don't believe they do. But yeah, I hate those statues. They are my most hated... Oh god. Hi. Just hanging out, huh? These guys, you can't kill. When you hit them, they go down, but then they get back up a few seconds later. But they don't have any projectiles or anything, so they're just a minor annoyance. Can't even kill them with dynamite. Want that revolver. Well, that ammo, I should say. Since I already have a revolver. I don't know what it's supposed to be. It looks like an alien to me. Like a traditional gray alien. What are the tall guys called? I don't know. I don't know the actual name for any enemies in this game. Except for the Shoggoth. Since I saw someone mention that in a forum. I don't know how they knew that's what he's called, but apparently that is its name. But that's a Lovecraftian monster, right? A Shoggoth? Shoggoth? I don't know how to pronounce anything in Lovecraft, by the way. Oh god! Fuck, stay away from me. I wish I could eat you, asshole. I just want to know, wonder what this ability is. Shrouded Statue. That gives you the ability to cloak yourself for a short time. I think it costs 10. Very, very useful. I don't think these things can shoot through the gate. At least I sure hope they can't. Probably not, since he just kind of walked away from me. Haven't seen any ways down yet. fucker. The fishmen are called deep ones. Good enough. Let's see. Real meat or fake meat? Fake meat. Damn. Nothing up here. Okay, let's head down. No, something killed this lizard. Ooh, I could eat this. I think I will. Alright, let's see if I can block this thing in without triggering it. Oh god. That's the sound it makes when you trigger it. See, this is why I love having the spell and the conjuration amulet. Because I can totally negate the effects of these statues. It is pretty nice. I'm being a little overly cautious here. The hooded guys are cultists. Yeah, that makes sense. I don't know what the lizards are, though. I don't recall any lizards in Lovecraftian lore. But then again, I haven't read much of it. Let's see if I can sneak up on this guy. Oh, crap. If I do, one of those other guys will see me. Great. Where'd the other one go? Is he up here? Oh! Whew. Okay. Wait, did I get hit again? I thought I had 4. Maybe not. Alright. I am probably exploring some of this unnecessarily. But you know, it's a roguelike. It's sort of ingrained in me to explore, even if it's at my own detriment. Alright, I'm eating you. I'm sorry. It's nothing personal. Oh, hey, a shop. Oh, too bad I just spent all of my money. But I can rob this guy blind, unless he immediately kills me because I stole from that other shopkeeper. Alright, let's see what happens. Hi. You don't know me. I've never shopped in one of these establishments before. Oh, you know, just looking around. Just seeing what you have to offer. This? Oh, you know, ignore this. This is... I don't know. I have this renovation streak in me, I guess. I just like building stuff. Doopy-doo-doo-doo. Oh yeah, I should have talked to that guy. He says something different, but oh well. So yeah, we'll steal that. Steal that, steal that, steal that. Compass again if I want one. Speed boots. I think I prefer my jump boots, actually. I guess I could at least show off the destruction amulet. It just lets you do that. That's it. It's helpful, but I definitely like being able to cast the block spell for 0 mana. Yeah, exactly. I built him a house. Technically, he should be thanking me. This is a tripwire gun. It lets you shoot tripwires instead of bullets. And then you can always just pick them up later and get bullets if you want. It's kind of useful, I guess. I don't know. I haven't really found a great use case for it. It's another tinning kit. Alright. I think I am out of here. Kind of wish they had a locksmith kit. in that store. I find them more useful in general than the tinning kit. Speaking of building a house, I am very cautious with these statues. For good reason. I have died more times than I care to admit to the lizard statues. And that is the best way to deal with them. Don't give them an inch. Oops. I'm glad I have so many keys. How much do the statues damage you? Just one or two, I think. But the oh god. Oh, fuck! But the thing about the statues is, once you get hit by them once, it's very easy to get hit by them again. Because it's hard to lose them. Another trap. God, I can't believe I fell for that. Literally. Actually, I lied. That's not the best way to deal with the statues. This is. Alright, where'd my dagger go? There it is. And I didn't kill him. Great. And that alien is going to make it hard for me to box him in as well as I want to. Now, if I can trap the alien down there, that'd be pretty cool. But I don't think that's going to happen. So I am just going to try to book it out of here. You have to get a good hit with the dynamite if you want to destroy those statues. It has to be right on them. At least in my experience. Oh god. It saw me. I don't know how, but it saw me. Run for it, Marty. Fuck! What? Oh. Statue got me. Nope, can't kill the statues with the pistol. Right, let's see what my death phrase is for this one. I turn my back on a creepy statue in a dusty temple of Nyarlathotep. Eldritchgame.com. Hashtag Eldritch. Was going so well. Yeah, that's kind of how this game is. Alright, well, that was a 3-hour stream. And, I think it was fun. Hope you guys had fun. I'd like to play these games. Well, probably not Nuclear Throne, at least until they add some more areas. But I'd like to play this game on stream some more. Did they spot you? It's instant death. No, but I was really low on hit points. I think I only had 2 left. And it did 2 to me. Oh man, I didn't even notice. Geophalajur. Thanks for hanging out in the chat room. And Rainer19, did I say hello to you? I don't remember. Oh. Anyway, thanks for watching. It was a lot of fun. Hope to do this again sometime. Like I said, I'm on vacation for the next 2 weeks, so I will definitely do another stream or two in that time. So, yeah, I'll see all you guys later.